Everybody has this problem sometimes. You get a nice photo, but you realize later on that your photo is underexposed. It's too dark, the colors look off, and you are disappointed. But don't worry, because in today's free Affinity photo tutorial, I'm going to show you various ways, actually I think four ways, if I remember well, on how to recover those photos and bring them back to their original glory. So, if you want to know how to fix underexposed photos, welcome to this tutorial. I'm going to show you how to do this in a step-by-step manner after our fantastic intro. Hello again, welcome back. This is Strato Ayani from Illumis.com, the YouTube channel and website where we want to help you take advantage of your gear in order to get better photos, to edit better photos, and why not create a successful business out of your love for photography. So if you are new here, please subscribe to our YouTube channel because each and every week we publish free tutorials like this one. So in this tutorial, what we are going to see is how someone can use Affinity Photo's native tools in order to recover an underexposed photo. I'm going to be using various methods and tools in order for you to be able to use the ones that fit or suit your style, and also the method that works best with each photo that you are editing. So without any further delay, let's dive into Affinity Photo and let's see how we can bring back the light to our underexposed photos. So as you can see here, we have a very dark photo and actually an underexposed photo, if I want to be precise. And I'm going to show you three different ways that you can use in order to fix photos like this. So the first way that you can go is by clicking here the adjustments menu and selecting, of course, the brightness and contrast adjustment layer. So what you're going to do, you're going to crank up the brightness, and as you can see, it does a quite good job in bringing back details, the light, the colors, etc. And if the colors are kind of faded out when you increase the brightness, you can slightly increase the contrast and get some of those colors and contrast back. Okay, this is a very fast, dirty and quick way, but the problem here is that if you play around with the brightness or if you play around with the contrast, you're going to see that the whole frame is affected. So if you have something that is very bright and you increase the brightness in order to get everything look nice and correct, on the overexposed areas or on the bright areas, you are going to probably get some blown out highlights, okay? Especially if you add some contrast to the brightness. As you can see here, we're losing some details, maybe here and maybe somewhere around here, okay? So it's a global way to fix your brightness problems. It works quite well sometimes. Sometimes it doesn't work very well when you have some very dark areas and some very bright areas that need to be fixed. Let's try another way. We can go over here again and we can try the exposure slider. So the exposure slider is actually making the whole photo a lot brighter by using a different algorithm. So for example, I'm going to crank up the exposure. As you can see, we're getting a totally different result. We need to slightly increase the exposure and get a bright photo right away. But you're going to notice that sometimes the exposure works extremely well. Sometimes when you have some very bright highlights, again, you're going to have them blown out like this highlight over here and this highlight over here on the ground. Of course, if these highlights are not your main subject, you might say, well, I don't mind. I just want to go in quickly, crank up the exposure and get done with it. But please remember that the eye always goes to the brightest spots within the photo first. So sometimes when you are using the exposure slider, you are going to get very bright spots like this, and the eye is going to be distracted and driven here, then here, and later on to the Vespa itself. But exposure is a very good alternative if you have a very flat photo with equal lighting across the frame. It's going to work very well and it's going to help you probably a little more, because as you can see, it speaks, let's say, in photographic terms. For example, if you hit the exposure at +1, you're giving +1 stop of exposure to the photo. plus 2 is 2 plus stops on the photo, etc. So you can control the exposure by using the, let's say, tool of stops, if you prefer so. Another method you can use is the levels. You can click on the levels adjustment layer, and right here you can see that we have already very dark photo again, but if we take the white level and push it to the left, you're going to see that we are getting a brighter photo. Now, you might reach a place where you get overexposed, like this spot over here, but you can always dial down and play around. And the good thing with levels is that you can brighten up the photo somehow independently. For example, you can play with the shadow areas by using the white level, and you can play around again with the dark areas by using the black level independently. Okay, so if you play around with the white levels, and I'm sorry, I think I'm mistaken, if you play with the white levels, you are pushing the brightness on the midtones and the very bright areas, okay, as you can see here, and as a consequence you might have your photo look a bit washed out. If your photo looks a bit washed out, especially in the color areas, you can take the black level slider and drag it slightly to the right, and this will add some more contrast to the photo and will also make your photos look more punchier in terms of color as well. So you have levels, and now I'm going to show you my favorite tool in order. I'm going to show you my favorite tool for correcting dark photos, and of course it's the curves layer. Now, the curves layer might be some kind of mystery to many, but actually it has a very simple way of working and premise. How it works is, let's say, a bit simple, if you know what to do. And let's break down the tool in order to help you understand how it works, okay? So on the bottom left corner, you have this dot or control point that controls the dark areas of the photo. So if you push this upwards, it's going to make them brighter, but also more washed out. If you push it to the right, it's going to make the dark areas a lot darker. And if you notice, we have a drastic change here in the black areas of the photo, but the white poster, the white lamp, the highlights here are barely affected, okay? As you can see, I'm moving this control point, but it's affecting mostly the very dark tones of the photo. This control point controls the bright areas of the photo, or the brightest, as I might say, and a little bit the mid-tones. So as you can see here, if I take this control point and push it to the left, it's going to make everything brighter, so the photo looks a lot nicer, okay? If I break it down, it's going to make the photo look darker. So as you can see, I'm independent, I can't say this word, I believe. So I'm using two independent control points, let's say it this way, in order to control the bright areas and the dark areas of my photo. And if I want to overall brighten up the photo and affect all the mid-tones, which means almost everything within the photo, except the very bright and the very dark areas, you can click here in the middle, okay? And by dragging this new control point you created in the middle, to the left and upwards, you're going to make your photo look brighter, okay? So all the mid-tones are controlled by this middle control point, and if you drag it to the left and upwards, you are going to make it brighter. If you drag it downwards and to the right, I'm sorry, you're going to make the photo darker. So, okay, Stratos, enough with the theory. What do we need to do? Well, in order to be able to work very fast, you need to actually take this control point and drag it to the left. If this fixes your photo, you are good to go and you have a very nice day. Now, if this doesn't work very well because your highlights are getting blown out, like this lamp over here, you can go back, okay? You can click somewhere around in the middle to create a new control point and drag this control point to the left and upwards, okay? And bring this back. So you can play with this control point, and as you can see, you are getting a much better result. Now, if your highlights are getting blown out, it means that this line over here hits the ceiling of this rectangle. So this means actually that your highlights are going to be blown out. So you need to unstack this line from the ceiling and you need to move it to the right. So you have a nice curve over here and nothing sticks to the top of this ceiling, let's say. So you can see now you have a very nice bright photo, but no highlights are blown out. And you can keep going to the left if you want. You can get a much nicer look. And this tool gives you a finer control on how your highlights, midtones, and shadows are going to be brightened up. Okay, so we have these tools that I just showed you. We have the exposure, we have the curves that I just showed you, we have the levels, and of course we have brightness and contrast. Now, if you use any of these methods to bring your photos back to life, you might notice that the colors are kind of faded. In order to fix this, all you have to do is go over here, select the vibrance adjustment layer, and make sure that the vibrance adjustment layer is on top of everything else, and simply increase the vibrance and just a little bit the saturation if you want to. Okay, so let's see. With this, those two small adjustments, we went from this photo to this photo. Okay, before and after, before and after. And remember that we're working with JPEGs, okay? If you want me to show you how you can lighten up photos that you took in RAW format, then leave a comment down below and hit the like button, and I'm going to make a similar tutorial for Affinity Photo in which I'm going to be using a RAW file and the developer persona in order to show you how to bring back RAW photos back to life and brighten everything within your frame in order to not miss or lose or have to delete a single photo again because it's slightly or largely underexposed. Okay, that was it for today. I hope I was useful. I hope that I brought you some value. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe. Also hit that like button if you like this video. You know how these things roll. And again, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments down below. I would be more than happy to help you out and give you some answers. Again, thank you very much for your time. And don't forget that you can find us also on Facebook at Illumius. If you search our name, you will find us there. You can like the page because we are creating a very nice small community on Facebook as well. And until next time, take care, happy editing, and happy salvaging those photos that are under.